Hi everyone, this is Dr. Kalyani from Team MDS Concord. So hope you are all doing very well. We've discussed most of the contents earlier. Similarly, we have one more important topic or the question, that's smoking and periodontics. We have a really good relationship, rather it's an integral part of our perio treatment or periodontal disease. So we always ask, the first question is the patient a smoker? Because that's going to determine everything we do. So that's why we want to speak about smoking and periodontics today. As usual, again, lots of researchers at the molecular level, clinical level, systematic reviews are there around in all the very, very esteemed journals of perio. But as usual, I would always like to suggest some things which you're not supposed to miss. That is that periodontitis, systemic disease association in presence of smoking. Moving on, smoking and periodontal disease. Again, there is one more in 2012, that is active and passive smoking assessment issues in periodontal research. So just go through the article, make sure the conclusion is read. That's it. Because most of the time it happens that few of them are good research articles, few of them are good reviews. So consider that before you, in fact, don't blindly just go read something and make sure how you're going to present that particular one which you are reading in your answer. Okay, then histological perspectives of theories of periodontal disease etiology. I have just included this for an idea, that's it. Moving on to the contents. In contents, again, it is very, very important to make a beautiful index. Here you have to write about the introduction, classification, types of tobacco, composition of tobacco, very, very important. Smoking as risk factor. See, prevalence in the population is not, we can always write, because it's not possible to remember the recent census. So it's good if you can just skip it, or if you can overall write something like in prevalence, that it's more common in case of males and in low social, like rather, you know, I'm just giving you an example, like how it is more common in which particular group of people. So that is more important. Prevalence and severity of periodontal disease in case of gingivitis, in case of periodontitis. Then clinical association, this is very, very, very important. Every basic person will read it. Microbiology, immunology and physiology. Methods of smoking cessation, tobacco cessation programs, again conclusion and references. Before moving on, for these chapters, like the association of smoking, association of systemic disorders and HIV, all this what we have is we have something called as Rosemalle and Genco. So all of us must be knowing it, but you really good find good points in those books. So apart from your Carranza, go through Linde. Linde also has given it very well. Then apart from that, go through Rosemalle, Genco. And these three books would be good along with some good articles around. So history, and here I have made everything in very, very concise way with even the studies, and everything is from 12th edition Carranza. So here if you see that introduction, history also is in the flow charts. Like what has happened in 1940 is in the first year, and at the end you can conclude with what's in the 1990 scenario. Then this is a common well-known flow chart of local and systemic problems. Okay, classification of habits by Sorin, neurosis, occupational habits and miscellaneous. Coming to type of tobaccos, you can just mention those names, then the composition, and if you can just make it in a little presentable way like this, it's good. Tobacco smoke, again gaseous phase, solid phase, main components, then how is it acting, especially the nucleus accumbens. So if this is the main part of action. So various studies from Larson 1961, Thayer's 1999, Cattaneo in 2000. These are the most important landmark studies. Everybody would be expecting you rather in the Viva or in your seminar, JCs, that how did it come? There was one person called Bernstam in 1989 who was trying to associate periodontitis with that of smoking. And is also given as a risk factor of 2.5. So you know odds ratio, how it is around 1, 1 more than 1 and less than 1. So 2.5 is something definitely to consider. Then McCurry et al. Study, then Hashim et al. Study, then there's one more study I think I've quoted later. Yeah, Asma Thomas study. Okay. prevalence after before the asthmatoma study, we have just some lines about the prevalence. Current smokers, former smokers, non-smokers, various classes. See, I was telling you, Thomer and asthma study. This is one important one again. Pack year. So, what's a pack year? And how do you define the number of, what's a pack year is what you need to know first. That's number of years smoked by the average number of packets per day. Okay, classification based on the pack years of smoking, subjects were classified as never, light, moderate smokers and heavy. So, you need to know what is active and what is passive smoking. Prevalence and severity of periodontal diseases is elaborated here. As this is a table which is given in Karan's as well. Effects of smoking on prevalence. So, the case control studies and the cross-sectional studies, what they have said and how are they concluded. Okay. Effects of smoking on prevalence of periodontitis. Again, the study, NAN survey. Then, clinical association of smoking associated periodontitis. I told you, microbiological part, immunology part and physiology part are very important. These lines have to be as it is. Microbiology, what are the studies there? I mean, immunology. So, how they are saying is in periodontal health. So, if you see, everything is in given a flowchart manner. So, writing your answer in flowchart is most important. Moving on to physiology. Some methods of smoking cessation. So, you will have to elaborate. Then, have the 5 A's program. It's a simplified version. AAR, ask, advise and refer. Pharmacotherapy, that's bupropion is the most commonly used medicine. Then nicotine replacement products, clonidine and nortriptyline are second line pharmacotherapies. So I have tried to include this one article which is published and given in trans-theoretical model. This trans-theoretical model has 5 phases, pre-contemplation, contemplation, preparation, action and maintenance. Then again we have some other agents like patch, gum, nicotine sprays, nicotine inhalators, non-nicotine agents. So side effects are always there with something. So that is, if you can mention, it's well and good. Then the tobacco cessation programs, whichever you can just remember. Like say 2015 is latest. So just remember it, that is from Quit Smoking as National Health Portal. So a good conclusion would really do well. Then these are the references as I told you. Go through Linde, Rosmalley, Carranza. These are all the books which I refer and those which there was one I told you article for which you need supposed to go. That is also included here.